So this building had not been built by the time of his death, but the rest of South Kensington had. That was always his plan. He spent £150,000 on 86 acres of land. It's not bad for property prices in Kensington these days. But this is South Kensington as it used to look. So there was one manor house on this land. It's called Gore House. The whole estate was the Kensington Gore Estate. And this is where everything around us started to be built. Now, the first building in South Kensington was, quite predictably, the South Kensington Museum. Now, the South Kensington Museum does still exist, but it does have a different name now. Anyone guess what the name is? The Victoria and Albert Museum. Not that hard to guess. Victoria and Albert Museum was the first building built on this site. And it was so popular, they had to build a tube station as well. So sorry if you've had to walk all the way from the tube station this morning. That was the first building, so it got its tube station down there. This one was the last. Everything else came up in between that. And Albert had always wanted to build a theatre. It had always been the centre of this site that he wanted to create. But he died before it was built. He had never wanted to name it after himself, way too modest for that. He'd wanted to call it the Central Hall of Arts and Sciences. It was only after his death in 1861, and then when Queen Victoria laid the first stone in 1867, that she decided to rename it to the Royal Albert Hall of Arts and Sciences instead. And you'll see his influence everywhere, because there are letter A's in this building all over us. So if you're at this end, have a look at that window, because they're carved into the brickwork on either side of the window. If you're on this side, have a look at the top of the stairs on the left. You've got gold A's in the banisters. You will see those all the way around this building. So keep an eye out. Outside of the windows and in the banisters, there are 13,500 gold A's across this. But she didn't want us to forget him. And I promise you, I'm not going to shut up of the sheer breadth of performances that go on in this building. And one of the exciting ones that we're really looking but does happen at the beginning of December. It's our tennis tournament. Full-blown tennis match takes place here every year, end of November and beginning of December. So it takes us 2 days to build the tennis floor and a day to take it down, and we play 4 days of tennis in the middle. It's quite exciting. Not amazingly Christmassy, but up here we've got our dinner parties as well. We do those earlier on in the year, and we call it Dinners Week because we're unimaginative with naming. We call it dinner parties. It takes 60 hours to build that floor, so quite exciting for us. And we don't want to have to keep building and taking down the floor every so often, so we do all our dinner parties in 1 week, which is quite nice. So I'm going to take you upstairs.
So that big red carpet comes all the way down here, goes down the stairs to the front door. Now you might be able to see it from there, it's in the box in the corner. Best seen from up those stairs if you want to have a look. Head up the stairs and look diagonally down below us and you'll see the Queen's front door right down there. That is her front door. It's a secret front door, as secret as we can get a front door slap bang on the side of the building. And it doesn't have a number on it, but you can probably guess where it is since we came upstairs
20 minutes before the show. And we don't allow any food or drink in the Queen's box. In the 1800s, it was considered the worst thing if you ate or drank in public, so banned from the Queen's box. So we give her a whole room to have her drinks reserved in, called the Royal Retirement. And you may have noticed the door today, which is quite beautiful. I love this room so much. Come around the room. It really does. That's the idea. So this is the Royal Retirement Room in here. This is Her Majesty of Queen's waiting room when she's here prior to the show. So those 20 minutes before the performance starts, she'll be in here, sits in the middle of the sofa over there, because these chairs are in the box when the Queen comes to visit us. And when we filled up the auditorium and quoted all the rules and the audience members, the Queen will tell us that she's ready to run the box and start service. And we've got a signal in the box. Underneath where that crown is on top, there's a light under it. And that light's off when we let people into the auditorium. When it goes off, that's a signal to the conductor that the Queen's ready to step inside. So he strikes up the national anthem, the audience stands up, and the Queen walks from here into her box to start the remembrance song. There's a quite nice system, we've done this before, not our first rodeo. But this room here is dedicated to the royal family. You probably guess that from all the pictures around the room here, but that's what I wanted to tell you about. Potted history of the royal family. Central level of box is where we were earlier, core all the way up. Now, as you might guess, Kelvin will say
And you can also see the pool box from here as well. Right.